गुड मॉर्निंग वंस अगेन। आई थिंक इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एजुकेशनल मैनेजमेंट एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एट अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल एंड एट अ लोकल लेवल, वेयर इन वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फंक्शन ऑफ लोकल बॉडी लाइक पंचायती राज इंस्टीट्यूशन लाइक सी आर सी बी आर सी लाइक काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग दैट वाट आर देयर स्पेसिफिक रोल इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशनल बॉडी एंड स्पेसिफिकली मोर स्पेसिफिकली वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ स्कूल्स। So I, as I remember that I have asked that we will start this session with a specific to the question answer doubt clearance session, and then we will move towards the function of some of the state body that are specifically meant for the management of school institution. So is there any doubt or any thing that you want to clarify in this session? Any kind of a doubt till now that whatever the discussion we had? Anybody?
No.
Achha. No from your side. From anybody's side? I have to see the chat box also. So in the chat box also there is a no question. So I think we can proceed further, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so so the next thing we will be discussing, and whatever the doubt or anything you will be having, so you just message in the chat box or in between when I will be open the session for the discussion, you can ask at that time also. Okay, so there is a one thing that I have left, and that I will complete, and then we will move towards the specific function of the different body at a state level in the management and administration of the educational institute. First, that we have left in the previous discussion, that was the role and a specific function of the municipal corporation in the administration and management of a school. Because when we see, if the area is a rural area, okay, so in that rural area we have a panchayati raj institution, but in the urban area we have a municipal corporation, okay, municipality area, like that when we talk about the Bhuvaneshwar. So in the Bhuvaneshwar, where the jurisdictions of Bhuvaneshwar is there, we don't have a panchayati raj institution, we have a municipal corporation, Bhuvaneshwar municipal corporation. Like that in the Rourkela also, Rourkela municipal corporation we have. So like that, those who are the urban area, in the urban area we have a municipal corporation instead of the panchayati raj institutions. The basic structure of the municipal corporation and the panchayati raj institution are more or less is the same, but however there is a difference in the structure. Okay, so we have already discussed previously that in the 74th amendment of the Indian constitution, the municipal corporation has been given a responsibility in the municipal area, in their municipal area. Suppose that I am talking about the Bhuvaneshwar municipal corporation, so in the geographical boundary of the Bhuvaneshwar municipal corporation, and like that in the other municipal corporations also, they have been given a responsibility for the promotion of cultural, educational and aesthetic aspect, means the matter which is related to the education, the matter which is related to the cultural aspect of that area and the aesthetic aspect of that area, to maintain, to promote, to strengthen those things. This responsibility has been given to the municipal corporation also. And in this context, when we talk that the 74th amendment of Indian Constitution and the responsibility that has been emphasized in giving the responsibility of promoting educational aspect, cultural aspect and aesthetic aspect to the municipal body, they have a specific function related to the education, because the function of municipal corporation about the culture and about the aesthetic will be beyond the scope of this discussion. Here we are mainly focusing about the educational aspect that the municipal corporation are supposed to handle. So in that context, the municipal corporation are required to control over the staff, means the distribution of staff, transfer of staff, providing the adequate number of staff. And this provision is in except that the recruitment and retirement of the people. Means suppose that we are talking about the teacher, that how many, suppose that in the municipal corporation there are 10 school, for sake of example. So for the each school, how many staffs are required, the teaching staff, non-teaching staff, supporting staff, as per the need and demand of that specific school. Need and demand means as per the strength of student strength, the transfer, providing the appropriate and the adequate number of teaching staff. It may be on the transfer basis. Suppose that some school is having less number of enrolled student and they are having the more teacher, and some school are having the more number of enrolled student and they are having the less teacher. So by the mean of the transfer and posting, so they will suggest the government that this type of a reshuffle of a staffing pattern is required among or between the school. And even if by the transfer and posting the adequate number of staff will be not met, then they will suggest the appropriate body for the recruitment of the staff, that is the teaching, non-teaching and supporting staff. But here it is necessary to mention that they are not enough empowered to recruit the staff. The phrase recruitment, they are not empowered to do, because the recruitment of the staff will create a burden of the financial aspect. So financial matter also needs to be taken care. But they can suggest, they can request the appropriate agency of the government for providing the staff, teaching, non-teaching and the supporting staff for the particular school. And transfer in the sense that if there is a imbalance within the municipal corporation area, then they can transfer. But if they are not getting the sufficient staff by the transferring, then the government may think of transferring the staff from the other area based upon the requirement. Okay, so that is the one of the specific function of the municipal corporation when we talk about the management of school. The second thing is that the municipality may build and create a specific structure of managing the school within their boundary. Means they may create, because we know that the government has already a specific structure that we will see in the next part, that when we will be discussing about the state, that how the state functions specific to the educational management and administration. But they may create some their own structure and a workflow for the appropriate management of the school. Here, when I am talking that they may create their specific structure and a workflow, means it will be applicable to that municipal corporation only. Means suppose that the Bhubaneswar Municipal Corporation is framing one structure, then it won't be applicable to the Rourkela or some other municipal corporation. Okay, so that is that. And they may create the some other academic wing also, like the academic wing for the research, the academic wing for the understanding the need assessment, academic wing for the micro planning. Okay, like that they may create, subject to the fulfilling the guidelines laid down by the Department of Education, because they cannot violate, because they are the subsidiary body, they are the subordinate body, so they cannot violate the rules and regulation that has been already laid down by the Department of Education. So by following those rules and regulation, they can create the some specific body for the management of schools. Then the next thing is that the municipal corporation also recruit, because the recruitment as a permanent staff, they are not empowered enough, but they can recruit the some the temporary staff on a contractual basis, or on the guest lecture basis, or on the temporary basis. That kind of staffing recruitment, they are empowered to do that. And obviously the finance that will be required for that, that is either met by the internal resources of the school, internal resources of the municipal corporation. School doesn't have, in fact, a very much strong economical point of earning, because the in the government school, the fees and every that is the financial structure that is supposed to be supported by the student is fixed. Means they are required to take as a tuition fees this much, and everything is fixed, and that needs to be expended spent on the specific budget head. Okay, so there is no very much scope of earning the finance from the fees of the student, but the municipal corporation are also having some of the internal resources, like as the taxes or the holding tax or like that. So they can support the remuneration of the temporary staff from that resources, or it can be supported by the government body also. And when we talk about the situation and the scenario in India, the temporary staff you must be knowing, like that the Sikhya Sahayak, or the some of the school have the guest teacher, like that. When you have went to the some of the government school for your internship, I remember in the university high school, some of the temporary staff have been recruited, Sikhya Sahayak have been recruited, because the number of permanent staff was less. So they were their salary were supported by the in the particular university high school, the salary was reimbursed by the university, the resources the university is getting. And when you will see that the other government high school, that comes under directly under the Ministry of Mass and School Education, that they are getting from the that department. So right, Pallavi, that is the para teacher also. In fact, when we see the different state, like the Orisha, West Bengal, Bihar, so they have a different nomenclature, like a para teacher, Sikhya Sahayak, Sikhya Mitra, like that, the nomenclature they have. But the function, the responsibility, and everything is alike across the state. Guest lecture is, however, something a different concept, where the people are called to take the classes on the class basis. Means they will be given the remuneration on the class basis. Suppose that 200, 500 per class will be fixed. So suppose that you are taking a 10 class per month. So it will be 5,500 per class on the basis that. So that is also their function. And the other function of the municipal corporation includes to coordinate the different committee that is at a district level, so that the proper functioning of a school and a collaboration between and among the different body can happen. So to coordinate the different body, and like that the municipal corporation is also responsible for the universalization of elementary education, universalization of secondary education. The point of saying is that whatever the policy, the program of a government is there, they are supposed to implement. Like that, it is needless to mention, like that the scholarship scheme, free bicycle scheme, that is the midday meal scheme. So they are supposed to implement in coordination with the district, state, and the other stakeholders in that area. So that they are supposed to do that. Okay, so that was all about the role and a function of a municipal corporation, a specific function of a municipal corporation in management of the school, management and administration of the school. So now we will go towards that the different body at a state level. What are the different body at a state level in the management of school? For that I will show you one structure. I am just sharing the slides here. One minute. Yes, that I wanted to show you. I think, is it visible to you? So, as we have discussed previously also, and we will connect all those things, because in the fragmented way we have discussed the agency for the management and administration of educational institute at a international level, national level, and at a local level also, and in between we have discussed something about the at a state level also. So when we see that at a state level, the highest authority in the state for the management of education is that the Ministry of Education. In some of the state, the Ministry of Education was already there, like that the West Bengal, and in the some of the state, the Ministry of Education means the ministry that is responsible for looking into the matter of education was as a Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So under the ministry there will be a secretariat, means there will be a different secretary, those who will deal the different matter and aspect of education. Means suppose that some will deal with the higher education, someone will deal with the research and innovation, someone will deal with the school and mass education, like that there will be some secretariat, okay, and within the secretariat there will be some directorate, as I have told that the directorate of teacher education, like then that in the Orisha we have a directorate of a TE and SCERT. Okay, so like that the different directorate will be there, and this directorate will be assigned a specific role and responsibility to a particular thing. Like that when we talk about the Orisha, and in Orisha we have a directorate of a TE and SCERT. So this directorate of TE and SCERT is responsible for looking into the matter of a teacher training, in service teacher training, pre service teacher training, and since the SCERT is attached with that, so they will look into the matter of the production, revision and the adaptation of the textbook. The textbook of different subject matter, textbook at a different class level, and a textbook for the different group of people. Suppose that some visual impaired children is there, so the production of audio textbook. Suppose that some auditory disabled children is there, so the production of the visual textbook and the tactile textbook, like that they have a responsibility to produce all those things. Together with that, the revision of a textbook at a regular interval, evaluation and a revision of a textbook at a regular interval, and they will also develop the curriculum framework, syllabus, and that the examination pattern in consultation with, here it will come when we will talk about the examination, evaluation, that kind of a thing, that will be in consultation with the board of secondary education of the particular state. Like that we have in the Jharkhand, Jharkhand Academic Council. Earlier, before that Jharkhand Academic Council, we had a Jharkhand School Examination Board and the Jharkhand Intermediate Examination Board. So in consultation with the board, they will develop, and they will also be engaged in the research and innovation, research related to the different pedagogical aspect, different assessment pattern, and the what is the ground reality at a school level. Like that the different kind of assessment and the innovation and research activity they will undertake. And this SCERT will again at a lower down, it will work in coordination with the regional or a circle officer, like that the RDDE, regional directorate, director of education. So RDD is the regional deputy director of education. So they will look into the matter, the RDDE will look into the matter of management of schools at a regional level. So for sake of example, 3, 4, 5 district will come in one region. So that RDDE or the regional or circle officer will take care the management part of the school in that specific region. And then after the RDDE, there will be the district education officer that will take care the need of the schools in that particular district. And obviously the district education officer will work with coordination with the Jila Parishad, because the Jila Parishad is the local body available at a district level, and they will also work in coordination with the Dyats, because the Dyat is the academic body. See, the DEO, that is the district education officer, is the management body. They will look into the matter, they will supervise, they will manage, they will do all the thing. But Jila Parishad is the elected body, and we know that in the Indian constitution, elected person is always have a higher position than the government servant or a government officer, and obviously the DEO post is held by the government servant. So in that matter, the district Jila Parishad will have a higher power, so they will work in coordination with the Jila Parishad. But again, we know that there is a specific need of the each district because of the diversity. Suppose that some district will be in the tribal area, some district will be in the hilly area, so their specific need will be different. One thing. The another thing is that SCERT at a state level cannot undertake all the work by their own. Suppose that for the training of the teacher, in-service training of the teacher on the pedagogical approach, the latest pedagogical approach that is in the in and around us. So suppose that there is a program to give the in-service teacher to the in-service training to the teachers. So SCERT cannot do all the things alone. So they will collaborate, they will work with the DIETs, and DIET will take care the need of the in-service training of the teachers. So that's why the DIET is also attached to the district level body of the education management and administration. Suppose that there is a need of conducting a research on the suppose that through the board examination it has been found that some of the school have had a zero result in the board examination or a very poor result in the examination board examination. So that type of a research can be undertaken by the district institute of education and training, that is a DIET, or that is the pedagogical approach adopted by the teachers of that district and their effectiveness. What are the pedagogical approach they are adapting and what are the effectiveness, like kind of a research project that can be undertaken by the DIETs. So at a district level, DIET, district education officer, and a Jila Parishad works together. Here it is also necessary to mention, within a district there may be some urban area, that is the Nagarpalika or municipal corporation, like that municipalities and municipal corporation, like that the small urban area they have a municipalities, okay, but the big urban area like a Bhuvaneswar have a municipal corporation. The basis of deciding that which urban area will have a municipalities and which urban area will have a municipal corporation, it is decided based upon the population of that urban area. Okay, so that is the doesn't a matter of point of a discussion here. So in a district obviously there will be urban area or there will be some rural area. So in the urban area, all other need that just before I was discussing, that will be taken care by the municipal corporation or the municipalities. Whereas in the rural area, there will be again one body, that is the block education officer, block education office, and that office will take care the need of the management and administrative part of the school in consultation with the village education committee and a gram panchayat, that is the Panchayati Raj institution. As I have discussed that the elected member have a higher hierarchy as per the rules and regulation, that is the norms of the Indian constitution, so they have the higher hierarchy. So obviously the block education officer will work in consultation with the gram panchayat and the village education committee. And previously, as I have already discussed, that by the amendment of the Indian Constitution, they have been given a legal status. Earlier, the Gram Panchayat were not having the legal status, they were not empowered. So now they have been given the legal status and they have been empowered to do all kind of a thing, and that's why they look into the matter of the school education and management. The next thing that will be see, that is this is the administrative operation in the state, how that that was the structure, that what are the structure of educational management, and this is the specific operation, administrative operation of the different stakeholder that are responsible for managing. As you can see that there is a Department of Education, and that will be linked to the Ministry of Education of the state. Ministry of Education means it may be Ministry of Education or Ministry of MHRD as specific to the state. And within the Ministry of Education, there will be a Department of Education, and there will be a Secretary of Education and Directorate of Education. They will work in consultation with the Department of Education, means Department of Education, Secretary for Education and Directorate of Education, they will work together. They will not work separately, they will work together. And after that, there is a regional or a circle officer that I have discussed, and they are responsible for the circle education officer, means that the management and the administration in the entire region or a circle. And then there will be a district office of education, that is district education officer, and then there will be a block education officer. And if it is a urban area, then it will go to the Jila Parishad. Okay, so that was the structure at state level. Now here we will have a small question answer session, and then we will move towards the different aspect of the things. Okay, is there any question up to here?
Yes,
because
sir.
I am not seeing any question in the chat box.
Yes, sir.
Sir, yes, please tell me.
वहाँ पे लिखा था district inspectors of schools.
Inspectors of
जो inspectors है अभी भी जो supervision है करना है.
अभी भी जो supervision है
तो inspecting some.
अच्छा okay. So I think your specific 1 minute. I think your specific question is about the district school inspector.
Yes, sir.
Isn't
yes, sir.
It?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Ha. So before discussing about that, I will tell you one fact. In the different state, the post of school inspector was there. Okay. As I remember, in the Bihar and Jharkhand, it was there. It was still there. Okay. But the fresh recruitment or by the promotion to a district education, district school inspector is not happening on a regular basis. Because I see my own district, earlier we had a school inspector, and they were performing their duty, their specific duty and function we will discuss. So they were performing their duty, but now I see in the majority of the state, majority of the district in Bihar and Jharkhand, school inspector is not there, and their duty is performed by the district education officer. Okay, in fact I don't have idea about the situation in the Orisha, I don't know, but this is the situation in the Bihar and Jharkhand. They had the post, they still they have a post, but the person is not there, either by the fresh recruitment or by the promotion from the lower post. So this is the situation as of now, I am ignorant of the situation. I don't know, I don't have idea about the situation of Orisha. But I hope that they must have the post, irrespective of where the real school inspector is existing or not. It may be questionable, it may be point of discussion, but they must have the school inspector post, obviously. Now come to the role, responsibility and a function of the school inspector. School inspector had a responsibility of inspecting the schools from primary level to secondary level, and nowadays up to a senior secondary level also, because earlier the senior secondary or higher secondary was a part of a somewhere in the college, somewhere in the, if we talk about the Bihar and Jharkhand as a intermediate college, in the Orissa in the, as a junior college. Okay, so they had a responsibility of supervising and inspecting the school, and inspection I will take the your query, let me finish that. So the inspection was on the basis that whether the teachers are coming on a regular basis or not, they are coming on time or not, they are performing their duties as per the requirement or not, proper daily classes are going or not, and the basic infrastructure are available or not, or the infrastructure are being used at the optimum level or not. Suppose that they have a library, so whether the students are allowed to use the library, they are allowed to take the textbook, they are allowed to sit in the library, or they have a provision of the games and sport, and they are being given the appropriate time in the timetable for the game and sport and the yoga and all the music and all those things. They are supposed to inspect, they are supposed to supervise and give the report to the higher authority. Higher authority, who will be here? Higher authority will be the district education officer. So they will be reporting to them, so that the appropriate action in terms of, if there is a no facility of game, sport or library, so to provide the facility. If the teachers are not coming on the regular basis, punctuality, so they will take action against the teachers, or if it is not being utilized, so they will take action, or they will give suggestion on how to utilize those things. So like that kind of function, a specific function they had, that is the school inspector. Now you have written the term inspection is autocratic in nature, so nowadays supervision is used. It is the different paradigm of the terms we are using. Even nowadays we are not using the word teaching, but it is widely and frequently used in the government document, government reports, because when we talk about the teaching, it gives the sense of a behavioristic approach. So now we are using the facilitator, who can facilitate, which is the constructivist approach term. But even the evaluation and the assessment, that we are using the term. So yes, there is a paradigm shift in using the word, which have a different meaning. Yes, I do agree, but the terms are frequently used. Okay, but you are right. Any other question apart from that?
No, sir.
No question?
Sir, would you?
No, sir. Loknath?
Yes, sir.
Haan, Loknath, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sudakshina is asking, what is the difference of two words, inspection and supervision? Acha, so she is asking the difference between the two terms. So when we talk about the supervision and inspection, actually more or less both word is same and they are used interchangeably. The basic difference is that when we talk about the supervision, supervision give a sense of the you can understand that it is a democratic in nature, means the supervision will happen in collaboration and a coordination with the person or institute to whom you are visiting. Whereas when we use the term inspection, inspection is a something the authoritarian word, means it give a sense that you are a authority at a higher hierarchy, those who are visiting and inspecting and are trying to find out the pro and cons, means the good and bad thing in their practices. Because when we talk about the administration and management of school, so their practices. Whereas when we talk about the supervision, it give a sense that you are seeing how it is happening. Here you are not being a judgmental. You are writing in a report that whatever you have seen when you have visited, so on your visit what you have found, so you have documented this and you have forwarded to the higher authority for the action. But when we talk about the inspection, immediately you are trying to find that what is the desirable, what is not desirable, means pro and cons. So it is a little bit the authoritarian word, whereas when we talk about the supervision, it is a more or less it is a democratic word. Okay, that is that. And one more question is that Mutindu, what is the NISTA program in education? So before the NISTA program, I will just wait 1 minute. Yes. Is this visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
So when we talk about the I have shown you the portal of the NISTA. It can be accessed at the nista.ncert.gov.in. So NISTA is the Government of India initiative to train the head teachers and teachers of the school on a different pedagogical approach, on a different management aspect of the school. The program learns on the blended learning platform, means some of the training will be online through this portal, the portal you are seeing, and some of the part will be offline, means the teacher will be called to the training place and they will be trained. So this is the basic mechanism of NISTA program, and the basic function is to train the teacher, head teacher and a teacher from a school education for improving the quality for the quality improvement. And the full form of this NISTHA program is the National Initiative. One minute. The full form is the National Initiative for School Head and Teachers for the Holistic Advancement. Okay, and the basic purpose is to improve the quality of a school education. Okay, and that is the centrally sponsored central government flagship program, and that is implemented via the NCERT, which is working in the school education. Okay, so that is the brief idea about the NISTHA program. Okay, so now I think we should stop the session here because it is already 5:53, and I have to go for the another class also of the AMED, and I think you have also another class at 11 o'clock. Okay, so shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.